Hello guys, this is Char, and welcome back to my channel. I'm sorry, I was trying to eat chocolate chip cookies. Those are my favorite. Baked chocolate chip cookies has always been my favorite. But anyway, I'm here to talk about Love and Marriage Huntsville briefly. Now, you all know that this season is lackluster for me, and I am going to stand beside that, okay? But they do have some special moments and some really good moments in certain episodes. Now, last night episode, Kimmy tried to initiate a truce between Stormy and Destiny. Now, Destiny, I'm going to have to side with her on this, that it's almost impossible to get through to Stormy because I'm not sure what bag she's coming out of. It's like she's trying to create a stance or a name for herself straight out of the gate. And okay, but the point is, we don't know you yet. We don't know anything about you yet besides she peddled some products, hair products. She has a hair product business. Okay, fine, that's great. And it apparently is doing really well, really, really well. That's fine, but you know, you got to establish a foundation, you know, a whole background, a whole storyline before you just come in just with the daggers and the drama and the, you know what I mean? So it's almost like she's just real nasty and rude for no reason. And you know, it's too much. And I'm going to have to agree with Destiny with walking away. That was just the best thing she could do. I mean, I'm not even going to give her no more energy. I'm walking away. Point blank in the period. Mel, she's more and more not liked this season, more so than ever, I believe. And we all love Mel over here. However, I am going to say, just as Tisha have said in a few seasons back, let this woman find out about her husband on her own. Just let her find out about her husband on her own, whatever it is. Or whatever it ain't. Stop trying to prove something to her. Stop trying to have some innuendo. She keep talking slightly about receipts, but never actually reproduce them. She pulled out her phone like as if she was about to go through her phone and find out something and show her something and never did. She just ended up leaving. Mel, let it go, okay? I understand that your husband have told you some stuff that is probably true because he knows, because he was there, because they were out there together. I get it. But like I said, she don't believe you. She don't believe the rumors. Let her find out on her own and let that be that. Okay? Before everybody start hating you. Okay? Now, on to Late Night with Carlos King. Great show. I love it. I've watched, this was the third episode or second episode. Last night was Dr. Heavenly and Martell. Now, Martell, he straight up was scared of Dr. Heavenly in that he did not want it with her. He didn't, because we all know Dr. Heavenly has a no-holds-barred mentality. She's raw. She's uncut. She says it as it is. She don't care about your feelings or whatever, and she will apologize for it later. And, you know, he felt a way, apparently, about her referring to coleslaw is coleslaw, and like she said, she didn't know her name. And even if she did know her name, that's what everybody was calling her, because that's what she was, a side chick. Now, where in America is it that you cheat with a woman, with a man's, or with a woman's husband, and you're not gonna be considered a side chick or a side piece, and they make up little names for you? I mean, that's just the way that it is. You don't like it, don't be a man's side chick. I mean, whatever. I mean, I understand he's trying to take up for his baby mama and all that, and that's fine. But it is what it is, Martell. Deal with it, and she needs to deal with it as well. However, he did actually state that he was not, is not, and ain't gonna marry her. Now, she should feel like a fool. She didn't sat up here and broke up a marriage, and this fool don't even want to marry her. She should feel like a fool, which I know she does. But anyway, Dr. Heavenly was letting him know, look, I didn't know her name, and that was the best I had, which was coleslaw. So that's what I called her. So she had to bite her tongue and hold so much back from not going off on him and her and really telling him how she felt about the whole situation. Now, I do have some sound bites from last night's episode with Dr. Heavenly and Martell. And I'm telling you, it was so good because toward the end, I feel like Martell really solidified the cheating rumor of Marcel Scott. I feel like he solidified it. To me, it's done. He has cheated because of how Martell answered the question. He basically said he hates what Marcel is putting her through. Currently is putting her through, because if they're just rumors, he would say, you know, something to the effect like the rumors are destroying them or yada yada yada. He didn't. He said he hates what Marcel is putting her through, and he doesn't know how much longer Tisha is going to be able to deal with what Marcel is doing. Now, to me, that was telling. Chills ran down my neck. I feel like he solidified it for me because he knows where bones are buried as it relates to Marcel, because they were out there together. So they know a lot about each other and what each other was doing out there, which is why Mel feels like she got a smoking 9mm in her Birkin bag. You know what I'm saying? That she won't never pull out. But listen to this. Check it out. Like, comment, and subscribe, guys. Bye.
I'll start with you first. What's that? Because I heard all y'all was at Melanie's party, and y'all was talking about my baby. And so was you. And so was you too, Melanie. My little niece came back and told me all the stuff that y'all had to say about Tisha, and I just
came to talk to the ladies that your niece told you was talking about Tisha.
You, Stormy, Melanie, and whoever else was there.
Everybody except your niece was talking about Tisha at the Christmas party. Is that what you heard?
All y'all. Every last one of y'all was in there talking about my daughter. I told her this right here. Tisha don't bitches that cannot buy shoes that comes in a box.
Footage that made you angry. I feel that if someone isn't there to protect the image, I don't think that you should speak on that.
I did not start that name. That's the only name I ever heard of. However, I am a wife. That is my husband. There's a big difference.
Any relationship, regardless if it's a friendship, boyfriend, girlfriend, husband, wife, it doesn't matter. I feel there's certain boundaries that outsiders shouldn't step in.
Absolutely. So you're getting married. That's what you're saying? You're thinking enough of this lady to make her your wife?
No.
Okay, then what are we talking about then?
I'm going to get married.
Get you something.
No, it doesn't matter. The disrespect shouldn't be there.
I did not start that name. That's the only name I ever heard. I did not know her name.
It's Ariana.
Okay.
It's my child's.
I want you to say wife. What is she to you?
No. She's my son's mother.
I don't believe in calling her the names in which has been attached to her, regardless of what people say.
However.
Go ahead.
You know what I'm saying? He talk about disrespecting women. Come on now. Let's not do this.
I mean, sometimes you grow up.
I mean, a name sometimes you grow up, and I heard.
So there's a different
level of disrespect he's done.
You repeated what you heard someone
else
say.
Absolutely, that's all.
So you're a little follower like a child.
No. I didn't know her freaking name.
Okay, so now that we
know yours.
So listen.
You've been saying my name for quite some time.
Remember?
No, you've been saying my name for quite some time.
Okay. You're not gonna play these games. Okay. You called me. I didn't even know who the hell you were. I knew Melody.
Look, we clipped it. You appeared on our love.